Hello everyone, it is me, Toby, back in the kitchen, which means that you know it is going to be another public gym video. It's actually going to be a two-in-one session because it is my first week back after Christmas in the public gym. It's going to be the January rush. It's going to be difficult to film. So I'm combining both my leg day and my bench, chest and upper day into one video for you guys of my entire week in the public gym. Because as you know, I do my first two sessions of the week in the public gym normally, and then the last two sessions with the strongman events and the heavy deadlifts in the garage gym, where obviously I have access to the specialised equipment and the ability to make a racket deadlifting. So, without further ado, today we are going to be doing a really heavy leg day. I say heavy, it's always heavy. And then we're going to be doing a bench day as well. So first week on a new block, last week we hit some pretty heavy numbers on both box squats and bench press. We'll focus on the box squats first because we are doing the leg day first. So last week we hit a 220 kilo single on the box squat, and this week we have got a 195 kilo set. It is a top set of five or more reps. Basically the program says if I feel good I can do anywhere up to three extra reps if I want, so technically it's a set of 5 to 8, and the reason I'm doing box squats instead of regular squats is that I injured my knee a few months ago now, and during the rehab of that, box squats didn't bother it quite as much as regular squats, and then since then we found the box squats have had a really, really good carryover to my deadlift power off the floor. And because in competition I have got deadlift for reps and no sign of a squat at all, there's no point in training a full depth competition squat when a box squat is giving me much better carryover to the event that I've got. So that is why we are sticking with the box squats for now. And yeah, so today 195 for a set of five or more. I know what happens because I'm filming this the next day. The reason that I'm combining the two sessions is because I wanted to do a sole video on yesterday's session, but on a Monday in January, after everyone's rejoined after Christmas, it was so horrendously busy I managed to just film my top set and the accessories. So without further ado, here is that top set of box squats. They moved really, really well at 195 kilo. I got 7 reps in the end. I probably had an 8th in me, but yesterday I was feeling quite naff, to be honest. I was feeling really lethargic. And it's one of those days that everyone gets where you just sort of can't be bothered. And obviously I'm going to get in and get it done anyway. But the fact I even got any extra reps is amazing. So I wasn't too bummed about skipping the 8th rep there. I wasn't even really skipping it was only if I felt good, and I didn't feel good, and yet I did 7, so I am really pleased with how they moved, to be honest. And then after that, as I said, I was feeling a bit rubbish, so usually my leg day accessories would be good mornings, hip thrusts, hamstring curls, leg extensions and planks, and I just sort of skipped the two heavier accessories of good mornings and hip thrusts, just because by the time I'd done that set of box squats, I was just done with being under a bar. You know, you get that feeling where it's like you've just hit a heavy set of squats and then you like your back off, so your next accessory, you just really don't want to get under a bar again in that session. So good mornings were off the table there, and the hip thrusts shortly followed them, because at the best of times I don't like hip thrusts, and yet I forgot my hip thrust pad, left, so that was a definite no-go on those. But we really hammered the hamstring curls, leg extensions and planks, so we still got a decent amount of work done, just not a full amount. But that was the leg day. I know it was short, I know there wasn't too much training footage, but as I said, I couldn't. Now we're going to move on to today's session, the bench press. So driving to the gym now, hopefully car cam isn't too bad. I don't think it was last time. But today for the bench press, we have got just a hell of a lot of benching. In the last program, the last block, we had heavy singles and doubles, and then a set of five, and then close grip bench. So that was, again, three technical bench things in a row. This session is even worse. It's we got four sets of three at 130 kilo, and then we got to back off with a set of 10 to 12. So it's the same sort of format of heavy bench, then bench for reps, and then you guessed it, close grip bench for three sets of 3 to 6 after that. So it's going to be a hell of a lot of benching, and I'm hopefully just be able to get a bench and stay there for about an hour in the session and just bench, bench, bench. But it's been really fantastic. It's been carrying over to my log massively. But yeah, in the last block, the end of the last block, I finally hit 140 on the bench. I got it for a triple, nice and comfortably. In fact, I'll insert footage of that here. So yeah, looked really good, felt really good. And as such, yeah, 130 kilo is what we'll be doing for four sets of three today. So that's just a bit mental, really. But it's going to be heavy, it's going to be fun. And each week we're going to drop a set. So it'll be four sets this week, three sets this next week, two sets the week after, and so on. And we're going to up the weight. So it should be a really good bench block. Fantastic for building the power for the log. You saw how all the strength press and bench pressing has been assisting my log in the last video, I'm pretty sure. I can't remember if that was a log video or not. But yeah, I'm going to film as much as I can in the gym of the benching, which will be inserted here. So that's the benching, and then after that we will be hitting just some triceps and some rear delts. So just the normal back off accessories for a chest and upper day, literally just some tricep extensions, rear delts. I won't film those probably, because for one they'll be very hard to film tricep pushdowns and stuff in the gym without a tripod, but also it's an exercise everyone really knows how to do. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get in and get the session smashed out, hopefully record a good bit that you will have already seen, and then I will catch you on my drive home for the end of the video. Okay, I literally just sat in the car after the session there. I managed to record a decent amount of the bench there. I got two sets of the regular bench and the set of 10 to 12, which was actually 8 to 12, which I got 11 on because I can't count to 12. Unfortunately couldn't record any of the close grip bench, but believe you me, I got it done and it sucked. After that set of 10 to 12, my triceps were pretty much finished, and trying to do close grip for sets of 3 to 6, I was barely getting three or four reps with the same weight I was blasting through 6 a couple weeks ago. So it's it certainly took it out of me. But what a really good session. The sets of 130 for three sets of four sets of three rather, absolutely flew, really, really smooth sailing. And what you can't see in the videos really is that bench that I'm using is the slippiest bench I have ever used. I don't know what material they've made it out of, but it's literally like trying to bench on a wet bench. Like, it's so slidey compared to my home gym one. So I just can't get my traps dug into the bench whatsoever. I can't get a really good strong position. So most of that pressing is literally just my arm pressing power. No lever advantages or anything, like no arch, nothing. It was proper nasty, but we got it done, and every single set moved the exact same. I could not tell you which sets the two that I filmed were, because they looked all exactly the same. It was actually set number one and set number three that I did film. And then, yeah, the set of 10 to 12 moved absolutely fantastic. The only reason I stopped at 11 was because I thought I'd already hit 12 and I counted wrong. Yeah, really, really good. Absolutely blasted through those. Again, pure pressing power because I couldn't get an arch or anything on those. And then, yeah, the close grip was the real killer there. Really finished me off. And then attempting to do any sort of tricep push down after that, I really had to lower the weight to what I'm used to. And then rear delts to rear delts. So overall, a really good session. The gym was noticeably quieter than yesterday, which was good. It means the January rush might already be over and it might just be a Monday thing. So that's fantastic. I got a bench straight away and I stayed on it, as I said, for about an hour. But yeah, so that's this video, really. Sorry it's a bit of a bit more of an informal, a bit more of a chill one. The quality's not going to be as good because I'm filming a lot of dark locations. But I thought it was important to get a video out for you guys anyway, because otherwise you'd probably be another week without a video, which is not ideal. Work's really picking up again, obviously, after Christmas. So the luxury of doing two or three videos a week while I had my two or three weeks off has now ended. So it'll be back down to about one video a week. But I am going to try and get as many out as I possibly can, because I know you guys really do enjoy them. The next video you'll see will be a home gym session, which are always better videos anyway. So stay tuned for that. I just want to thank you for the massive amount of support recently on the channel. Over Christmas was one of my best periods on the channel, period. Like, so many of you guys tuned into the videos, so many new people turned up, and a lot more faces commenting as well, which is always fantastic. My favourite thing about doing these videos is getting to read your guys' comments and interact with you. I've noticed a few of you come over to Instagram as well. Again, fantastic place to interact with me. So if you haven't done so already, please go ahead and follow me over on Instagram at Toby Lifely. The sessions that you don't see in video form on here, you will see over on Instagram, because I film my top sets of every session regardless to send to the Coach Laws. So I post them as well over on Instagram, and then obviously the sessions that I record longer form content get uploaded to YouTube. So if you're that interested, please go and follow me over there. But otherwise, if you made it this far in the video and you haven't considered hitting subscribe, please go ahead and do so. It'll help me out massively with my goal of 1,000 subscribers by the end of 2024. According to my future projections, that is manageable. So we're going to gun for it. We're going to try and get it. And I want to get it soon. It's one of those milestones that I've had for a long time. And 2024 will be a fantastic year if I manage to hit both 1,000 subscribers and a 300 kilo deadlift. That is the plan. That is what we're going to do this year. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. I've been Toby. I've got to get myself home now, and I will catch you in the next video.